Welcome to the Dam Owner Academy, brought to you by the Association of State Dam Safety Officials, or ASDSO, a series of videos to educate and inform on all aspects of operating and maintaining a dam safely. This video will cover removing a dam. Although most dams provide safe and reliable benefits, such as water supply, flood control, hydropower, and recreation, there are many dams that no longer serve a viable purpose or provide significant benefits. Many have exceeded the life expectancy of a dam, become structurally unsound, and present a risk to public safety. These dams may require costly repairs just to bring them into compliance with state and federal safety regulations. Many owners choose to remove an aging dam that is no longer providing benefits rather than repair or rehabilitate the structure. Dam removal can eliminate ongoing maintenance costs, alleviate public safety concerns, and reduce financial and legal liability. But a dam removal project doesn't come without challenges. This video provides an overview of the process to help you plan for a removal project or compare removal with other alternatives. A dam removal project may involve eliminating the entire structure or modifying it to remove its hazard and function as a dam. Either way, removing a dam can significantly alter the upstream and downstream environment and create a diverse array of impacts to stakeholders, including the general public, upstream and downstream property owners, local wildlife, regulatory agencies, and others. If you're contemplating the removal of a dam, here are a few of the considerations that should be a part of the planning process. Removing a dam often has positive impacts to public safety through removal of in-channel hazards. Removing a dam can improve fish passage, creating better aquatic diversity. But a dam may serve an important role in limiting the spread of invasive species, such as sea lamprey. A dam removal can restore the natural movement of sediment and nutrients in a river. However, there may be a significant volume of stored sediment upstream of a dam that requires costly removal, especially if contamination is present. Dam removal often increases the navigability of a waterway, but it may also affect recreational opportunities upstream by removing the reservoir. Removing a dam may affect the property values both upstream by removal of a lakefront and downstream through loss of flood protection. Removing a dam changes the hydrology and morphology of a channel, which can result in impacts to local groundwater levels, bridges, buried utilities, and more. Finally, a dam may be considered a historic structure with significance to local culture and heritage. Historic preservation laws may require careful navigation as part of a dam removal project. The financial cost of removing a dam is often one of the biggest considerations in evaluating a project's feasibility. Costs can vary significantly depending on the size of the dam, what it's made of, site access, sediment requirements, and the extent of upstream and downstream restoration. Removal costs often range from tens of thousands to millions of dollars depending on the dam and its condition. In addition, nearly all removal projects will require hiring a professional engineer for planning, permitting, design, and construction oversight. Contracting with a consulting engineer who has specialized experience in dam removal projects can save you significant time navigating the complexities mentioned earlier. Additionally, an engineer may be able to help identify sources of funding or grants to help offset the cost of removal. Let's go through the general steps for a dam removal project. Of course, every project is different, but this can give you a sense of what's involved. First is site reconnaissance, gathering all the information that will be used through the permitting and design phases. You should determine the age of the dam, the history of its construction, and any significant modifications. Review legal rights, including water rights, easements, property boundaries, and other permits related to the structure or its reservoir. Perform a site visit to identify any infrastructure that might be impacted by removal, as well as biological resources that might be affected, such as wetlands and wildlife habitat. Measure and conduct tests on the sediment upstream of the dam to identify volume and any contamination. Assess the historical significance of the structure and its eligibility for listing on any historical registries. Finally, assess the interests and concerns of the local community. Once reconnaissance is completed, the next step of the process is to perform a feasibility study. This should involve performing engineering analysis on changes to the dam's hydrology, hydraulics, and sediment mobility, developing conceptual plans for removing the dam, sediment management, and restoration of the channel and surrounding environment, identifying the permitting requirements for the project, analyzing site-specific issues like utility impacts, endangered species, and historic preservation, estimating the costs involved with the project, and exploring funding sources to support removal of the dam. Once you have a conceptual plan for the removal project, you should coordinate with all the stakeholders who might be impacted to avoid surprises. Hold community meetings, if applicable, to present alternatives and gather comments. Additionally, coordinate with all regulatory agencies who might be involved in the project to clarify and confirm their requirements. Your goal with this phase is to identify all of the challenges and concerns that are likely to arise during final design. When you feel like the scope of the project is understood, the next phase is final engineering. Here, you will work with an engineer to develop plans to remove the dam and restore the stream and surrounding area. You'll also develop project specifications, such as what equipment can be used, what materials are required, and the project's sequencing, staging, and access. You'll apply for all the permits needed, attend public hearings if required, and address comments from all the applicable regulatory agencies. Finally, your engineer will provide an opinion of the probable construction costs for the project. Once you have bid documents and permits in order, you can hire a contractor to begin construction during the appropriate season. It's important that the engineer is involved during construction to help answer questions, oversee the work, and provide confirmation that everything was carried out according to the approved contract documents. In addition, you may want to have a qualified inspector on site during the work to ensure its conformance with the plans. Removing a dam is a complex process, but there are many organizations that offer help. If you're considering a removal project, reach out to your state dam safety program, state environmental protection agency, and state historic preservation office first, as they can provide guidance in getting started. In addition, American Rivers is a nonprofit organization that provides guidance for dam removal and restoration, including some options for funding. Finally, the Association of State Dam Safety Officials has free resources available to help owners operate and maintain their dams safely. They have dam removal case studies that can help you learn more about the process. Check out ASDSO's website at dammotor.org for more information.